All right, it is Joshua Vergara from Android Authority. What's going on, everybody? Now, here's the one that I really wanted to get into. The Sony Xperia Z is definitely one of my favorite phones, but it just might be eclipsed by the newly announced Samsung Galaxy S4, which you see over there on the left. We're going to be taking a look at a couple of the... Let's start off with the benchmarks, because those are always a great way to start. So, we have our benchmarks over on the side. I saw it over here. Now, the Sony Xperia Z, you can already see it right here. There's a difference here. The Samsung Xperia Z was the first phone that I have ever personally used that broke the 20,000 barrier in Antutu benchmark. But look at the Samsung Galaxy S4. You got 25,900 on there. That is an incredible score, and it's the highest one that I've ever seen happen right before my eyes. Earlier, when we were looking at a Geekbench benchmark, we saw that there was a Qualcomm ARM V7 in there, which we were not told what the processor was going to be in here. None of the presentations talked about it. A Qualcomm ARM V7 at 1.89 gigahertz. That's a pretty powerful chip indeed, and it is really powering what is shaping up to be one of the most powerful Android phones on the market, and it's going to be. The Sony Xperia Z, on the other hand, does sport the Qualcomm Snapdragon S4 Pro processor that has powered a lot of great phones in the past, like the Nexus 4, but now they have all been eclipsed by whatever is inside of the Samsung Galaxy S4. Aside from that, however, you do have some similarities here with the 5-inch 1080p screen that is found on the Xperia Z and is also found here. However, the screen that we saw that had a little bit of color problems in the Xperia Z probably is going to get blown away because the Super AMOLED technology that Samsung is well known for is found inside of the Galaxy S4. And as you can see, the colors really pop out of that screen. Like I said before about the S3, is that the colors pop out and pretty much punch you in the face. That is basically what's going on here with the Samsung Galaxy S4 with its Super AMOLED 1080p 5-inch display. Aside from that, however, you're going to see that the form factor is a little bit different on the Xperia Z. You do have a more angular, rectangular design on here versus the usual pebble rounded design of the Samsung phones. The thickness is actually quite comparable, as the Xperia Z and the Galaxy S4 are very, very close, but I will say that at 130 grams, the S4 is definitely a lot light, well, not a lot, but it definitely is noticeable how much lighter it is. It's very easy to use, it's very easy to have in the hand because it's very light, it's very nimble, I should say. Of course, you're seeing one of the accessories that's available for it. It's a replaceable cover that has a flap over on the top that allows you to close it, and you still see some information on the top. So that's a nice accessory to have. And of course, it's a smart cover. So you open it up, and it wakes up the screen. So a couple last things about this. I will say that the 2330 battery that's found in the Sony Xperia Z does do a decent job, but you get 2600 inside of the Samsung Galaxy S4. One other thing that you should know is that the back of the Samsung Galaxy S4, as you can tell because there's a new cover on it, it's removable, which means that the battery is removable, which means the battery is replaceable. That's something that the Sony Xperia Z cannot say because, of course, it is a unibody design. You cannot take the battery out and you're kind of stuck with what you got. So, once again, Samsung gets a lot of things right with the Samsung Galaxy S4. I've been saying Samsung a lot in this comparison, but that is because that is what we're all about here at the event, the launch party for the Galaxy S4 at the Radio City Music Hall in the heart of Manhattan in New York City. So we're going to bring you even more comparisons. We're going to keep getting all the coverage that we possibly can for you because this is AndroidAuthority.com. It is your source for all things Android here in New York City.